Apache eCharts is an outstanding library to create any visualization you possibly could think of. From the basics like lines, bars, pies, and scatters to more advanced ones like radars, box plots, theme rivers, graphs, and many more. Every element is customizable. Just check out those various depictions of the gauge chart. They look as if they were created by different software, but no, it's merely visualization flexibility. Apache eCharts panel is an open source plugin that allows you to incorporate Apache eCharts functionality onto your Grafana dashboard. Apache eCharts has a data mining engine that lives in a separate library, ECStat. The latest update of the Apache eCharts panel now includes ECStat. That means you can perform complex mathematical and statistical operations within your Grafana dashboard. Watch this video to learn more about ECStat in the Apache eCharts panel for Grafana. Let's go! Installation. ECStat is already included in the latest version of the Apache eCharts panel for Grafana. No extra steps are required. Just make sure you updated the Apache eCharts panel to at least the 3.7.0 version. Documentation. ECStat is a separate library. As of now, it's not added to the official documentation page of the Apache eCharts library website. This one. However, there are a lot of examples using this library. There is no way to tell which example is using it just by scrolling the main page. You need to know what you are looking for. For instance, the scatter section, the linear regression chart, is built utilizing this library. The documentation for the ECStat tool can be found on the GitHub in the README file. You can skip the installation part since the installation has already been done for you. Then in the API reference chapter, you can see histogram, clustering, regression, and statistics sections. Let's review them one by one. One little thing to point out before I start. Standalone is when you use ECStat outside of Apache eChart as a separate library. I'm not going to cover this option right now. Histogram. For the histogram demo, the documentation references the example from the custom section, histogram with custom series. So, how does the histogram feature work? I will copy this code from the Apache eCharts website example page and paste it into my Grafana dashboard, Apache eCharts panel, Monica code editor, right here. Replace option equal with return, and here we go, the visualization is displayed on my Grafana. Histograms, as you know, are bar charts where every bar represents how many data elements from your dataset are in each range. The trick is to figure out those ranges, how many of them should be, and clearly they should not overlap. And this is what ECStat histogram feature does. It takes your data and computes the number of ranges and how many data elements belong to each range. The library has four inbuilt methods to do so. The default method is square root. The other available methods are Scott, Friedman-Diaconis, and Sturgis. If you need any of these three, make sure to specify it in the config for each transform. Let's review the code. It starts from the registerTransform function, specifying to use the histogram feature. The other options would be clustering and regression, and I will talk later about those. This example starts with the dataset parameter. I will temporarily remove some data points to make it easier to see what I'm talking about next. We have three datasets in here. The first one is called the source. It is a two-dimensional numeric array. The second dataset is the result of the histogram function applied to the first column of the source data. If nothing is specified in the config, then by default it means the first dimension. Dimension here is the same as columns. The third dataset is the result of the histogram function applied to the second column, or dimension with index 1, since all numeration starts with zeros. Later on, those datasets are referenced with dataset index, which also starts with 0. So you have dataset index 0 for source data, dataset index 1 for the first histogram application, and dataset index 2 for the second histogram application. To make this demo a little easier, I will change the color of the second histogram to red by specifying it here in the series properties. Great. Now I have the source data in blue, the first histogram in green, and the second in red. Let's get back to where we were. The grid percentage is simply the location of each chart. I will move the source chart by changing top to bottom, right to left, and the others to the opposites to demonstrate how the location works. Here is both depictions side by side for comparison. The x-axis and y-axis properties are pretty self-explanatory. Just note that we have three of each since these analytics consist of three charts. For series, the most important properties are x-axis index and y-axis index, since it tells which chart area should be used for displaying the data points. And the data index means which data to show from the datasets array. Let's move on to the next feature, clustering. To demonstrate, I will do the same as I did for the histogram. I will copy the code from the section Scatter Scattering Process Example. In the end of the code in my Grafana panel, I add Return option. Click Apply since I want to look at the results on the bigger screen. This chart was created specifically to demonstrate the steps the clustering algorithm makes. I can go from the step 0 to step 5 and get an idea of the clustering along the way. Optionally, I can click this play button and watch a little movie. Another example is what I recommend using as a starting point when working with clustering. The same section, scatter, and the same name, scattering process, but data points are colored. I copy the code, replace option equal with return, and see this error. The reason is in the example code, we have data as the data points array name. Data is a reserved word for the Apache eCharts panel. All reserved words you can find in the documentation located here on volkovlabs.io website, Apache eCharts panel section, then set option function chapter. So I replace data word with something else and the chart works fine after that. The example code starts with letting the panel know we are going to use clustering. Then data points are declared as a constant. Your data points obviously will come from a data source. If it's not yet available for you for any reason and you want to experiment as if it's available, you can use the static data source. I have a video explaining how it works. In a nutshell, a static data source is a storage place on your dashboard where you can mimic any data structure you need. Right after the data parameter, two other mandatory parameters are specified. The number of clusters, how many groups you want to split your data, and the dimension for the index. The word dimension seems misspelled, but it's okay, right? So you send the data array for processing and the algorithm will send it back with that index, and the algorithm needs to know in what column to place that index. It exists since you can send as many more columns / dimensions of data. The algorithm only uses two. The other can contain metadata like titles, descriptions, and anything else. The following steps define the colors of the clustering and which color the algorithm should use for clustering differentiation. This later on is used in the visual map element. Visual map is a standard for any Apache eCharts visualization. It's not unique for any chart in particular. Next, two datasets are declared. One is the source and the other one is the result of clustering. Here we're assigning two mandatory parameters. Later on, the second dataset is used in the series. The source data is not used for visualization anywhere. If I change the data index from 1 to 0, the visualization loses all coloring since there is no dimension cluster index in the source dataset. Regression. I will use the example from Scatter polynomial regression for the regression demo. Copy the code, paste the code into the Apache eCharts panel in my Grafana dashboard, replace option equal with return and data name with some other name. I will use data example instead. In the example code, the first line is to turn the regression feature on, then some data points example. As I mentioned in the clustering, you can use the static data source to mimic your production data. For that, I connect the panel to the static data source, add field X, data type, number, add field Y with the same data type, number. Next, I create the data points I want. Then in the panel code, I declare an array data example underscore from underscore static. Read the X and Y columns and return them as a two-dimensional array, but with the data from my data source. I need the zero index here since I might have multiple queries on the right. In my example, it is only one with the default name A, but I can add and populate many others. In the dataset option, I have two datasets. One is the source and the other one is the regression results. Here in the config, you must specify the type of trend you build. The options are linear, exponential, logarithmic, and polynomial. Order obviously has meaning only for polynomials. If I change it to 1, I get the linear regression, but I want to keep 3. Scrolling down, making sure the data index is set to 1. That is the dataset generated by the ECStatRegression function. The rest of the parameters are standard for Apache eCharts and are responsible for visual representation. Statistics is a collection of mathematical functions. They all require a list of numerical data points. To use, call the function like this. I will use the value I get in the chart title for the demonstration. I covered a lot in this video. Check out the description box below to find useful links. Join our sponsorship club on GitHub. It is a great way to say thank you for our work and ensure your questions and requests get the deserved attention. Thanks for watching and see you next time.